Welcome everyone to our AC Antiverse. Night has fallen and everything is still. The whole world is asleep, but the ants are up working their night shifts within the safe havens of their carefully crafted palaces. At Silver Rock Canyon here, the Dark Knights are busy making their way to and from their newly introduced nest. But little do they know, there's something creeping along their escarpment, snooping around the fringes of their territories. Who is that? It's a black crazy ant! Oh no! Have the Dark Knights found a breach in our tubes? Have they found an escape? It's over! Now hold on one sec. What will surprise you is this ant is not a member of the Dark Knights. No, she is an outsider. AC Family introducing feral ants. Today we take a look at the ants that live on the outside. Ants with free roam of my place. Now hold on, I know you're thinking, ew, gross, what? His place has ants? Well, actually, here in the tropics, we have no choice but to deal with domestic ants, and I'll explain why in this video, and show you what it's like to literally live with ants. And as a special treat, many of you have been asking for humane ways to help get rid of pest ants from your home. Well, I'll cover that too, and separate the truth from the myths. You won't want to miss all of this wild ant goodness ahead, so AC Family, let's take a step back and turn our eyes upon the outsiders, the savages of our ant world, as we look at feral ants in this episode of the AntsCanada Ant Channel. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Hope this video doesn't make you itchy. Enjoy. It's garbage disposal hour. And my trash is about to be tied up and picked up to be taken far away. Out on my balcony, where all organic trash is kept, the collecting smells are attracting some wanderers. Let's look. Black crazy ants are brewing, scouting the area for any food they can find. Believe it or not, here in the tropics, no matter how clean you keep your place, you're forced to deal with ants just like these. They manage to find their way around and inside your home. It's just an inescapable fact of life. They make their unwelcome entrances through various holes into the home, like, as in my case, through the drainage and piping. These black crazy ants visit my home every afternoon, right before my garbage is disposed and carried away. So just for kicks, let's summon forth these feral black crazy ants, shall we? Let's give them a taste of the rich delicacies our Dark Knights get to enjoy. Let's give them some decadent raw honey imported from Canada. Surely something these feral ants have never tasted before. Savages, come show yourselves! Okay. Come on. Don't be shy. Alright, one ant discovers the honey, and soon a second. But it runs off to tell the colony. A third worker, followed by more. And notice how some of them decide not to stay to eat, but instead run back to the colony to tell them of the news first, so they can get more members to the site as soon as possible to drink up the food. And here comes the rest of the colony now. Efficient little ones, aren't they? These black crazy ants are the same species as our captive colony, the Dark Knights. But let's take a moment to compare their differences. The Dark Knights versus the savage tribe of black crazy ants. Shall we? Okay, our valiant Dark Knights here, with the exception of the queens, were all born in captivity under the watchful care of we, the AC Family. Always protected from predators, the elements, and stress. These ants, however, born from the savage tribe, were all born in the wild, having grown up constantly on the move, dodging a plethora of animals wanting to eat them, dealing with challenges like disease, rain, and other competing feral ant colonies, all while chasing vital resources like food and water for their entire lives. And speaking of food, one could say our Dark Knights have it pretty good, as they get fed every day, various morsels, and for them it simply just falls from the sky. The feral ants, however, have to work for it, actually needing to forage for their food. They search high and low for it, and I'm certain they move from condo unit to condo unit in my entire high-rise building, looking for homes with available food. And when these feral ants can't find food in my place, guess where they look next to steal it? Our ants. Watch this feral ant trying to look for ways into the Dark Knight setup. It can smell that there's food inside, that our Dark Knights are well fed. I see ants from the Savage Tribe trying to do this, even though the Dark Knights would totally kill this ant had it entered the Dark Knight's kingdom. That is how desperate these savage ants are. I actually see ants from savage tribes checking out the Dark Knight's territories often. Sometimes, I imagine these savage ants wish they could join the Dark Knights. Look at it just standing there. Could it be hungry? Sad? Both? Okay, cute Ariel's part of your world song. Perhaps this is proof that it's truly better on the inside. The persistence of these feral ants is actually quite admirable. And it's this persistence that keeps my housekeeper and I on our toes, forcing us to go the extra mile to keep my place as clean of food as humanly possible, so these feral ants cannot find a single crumb of food anywhere. AC family, so check out what I gotta do because of these ants. First, as mentioned, all organic waste is kept outside on my balcony and never left sitting in my kitchen or anywhere in my home. Not under the sink in a bin like my family used to do growing up in Canada. And it absolutely must be disposed daily. The garbage man picks it up every evening. Next, as an avid coffee drinker, all sugar and creamer must be pre-packaged and not just sitting open inside jars. No matter how tightly fitting the jars are, the ants find a way inside. Also, get this. Anything open, including boxes of cereal, oatmeal, chocolate bars, coffee beans, trail mix, fruits, pretty much food of any kind, even if they don't require refrigeration, must be placed into the fridge. I mean, the silver glacier. So it is untouchable by feral ants. And our famously treasured honey, which cannot be placed in the fridge because it would be rock hard, must instead be protected by a moat in a bowl of water. But not so fast. Ants haven't survived for millions of years and a mass extinction for nothing. Some feral ants are extra crafty. Despite all these measures, sometimes the ants are able to catch things we humans overlook and find ways to get what they need from us. Presenting my aquarium, a dangerous pool of fish that would relish any ant that had the misfortune of slipping in. But look, if we inspect closer, despite the swirling pool of death below, there are some feral ants that are managing to steal from the very menacing fish that wish to eat them. AC family, these little thieves are destructive ants. Trichomyrmex destructor. These ants are small enough to fit into this tightly sealed container of fish food, right through the spaces between the ridges that keep the lid screwed on. These buggers off! Guess I need to put my fish food into the silver glacier as well. Unlike the savage tribe of black crazy ants, these destructive ants are new to my place. They must have moved in this week, and now that I've removed their bounty, they'll probably move out in the next couple of days. We gotta give it to them though. Assuming the destructive ants came in from somewhere outside, the fact that one ant managed to wander around my place, find this container of fish food, then travel all the way back outside to tell its family is pretty amazing. That's some hundreds of thousands of miles of foot travel if it were the size of a human. Now, the destructive ants are not the only new kids on the block. There are also some other tiny ants that moved into my place just a month ago. AC family, introducing to you, ghost ants. Tapenoma melanocephalum. I used to have a colony of ghost ants, but gave them to a friend after acquiring the Fire Nation and the Dark Knights. Well, turns out, a few months later, a feral colony of ghost ants decided to move in, and they have a likening to the Golden Empire and the Dark Knight setup. Let's give them a bit of our ants' cherished honey too, so we can get a better look. These ghost ants get their name because of their dark heads and semi-transparent gasters, which make them kinda look like they're floating ant heads. And guess what? I discovered exactly where in my place they were setting up residence. No, not my laundry bin. I don't think anything living can survive in there. But venturing in my walk-in closet, I followed them up and into my drawer, where I keep some old books. Those little sneaks. So what am I gonna do about these ants, you ask? Well, surprise of the century, nothing. I sort of don't mind that they come reside temporarily at my place. They're a bit of a nuisance, yes, but as mentioned earlier, ant colonies like these come and they go, and they're an inescapable part of life in the tropics. And for you AC family members who do live in a tropical country, that might be saying to yourselves, so you mean there are places in the world where it's not normal to have ants living in the home? Yes. I know in Canada and US, if you find ants in the home, it's a very serious and troubling matter for most. Once I had a family member visit from Canada, sleep over for the first time. And just as he was about to head to bed, he saw a trail of ants on the floor. I told him not to worry, as the ants are normal. He then told me he was checking in to the nearest 5-star hotel. Oh well. One reason I don't mind these feral ants being around is that they prey on other bad pestiferous insects, like termites, from entering my place. Plus, the ants are food to the cute house geckos which appear here and there, and which I also don't mind sharing my place with. Only thing is, they leave me presents periodically that I need to clean up. Okay, but what if you're not as willing to share your home with feral ants? Understandable. How do you get rid of pest ants in the home safely? Well, there's good news, and there's bad news. Bad news first. The bad news is, in most cases, there is no 100% surefire way to evacuate pest ants from a home humanely. The only way to get rid of ants with the most certainty is to hire an exterminator. But even then, the ants can come back, so you'll need to hire the ant killers again and again. Okay, but the good news is, there are ways to help discourage ants from staying with you after they've started to appear in your home. Let's go over them. First, I want to settle this big cucumber theory once and for all. I've been hearing people say that ants hate cucumbers. So let's conduct an experiment and try placing a slice of cucumber around these ants and see. Unfazed. Maybe a second slice? Nope, doesn't look like the ants really care about the cucumber. And some ants are passing right through between them, stress-free. Okay, so the cucumber method is a flop. Let's cover some effective methods I recommend. First, vinegar. This is your secret weapon to destroying pest and traffic signs and billboards. It is the bane to their ant Google Maps, so to speak. You see, ants communicate through pheromones, biochemicals laid on surfaces that tell ants various things, like where to go for food, where to go to find the nest, etc. So I suggest that when mopping, use vinegar as it is effective at breaking down biological compounds, including the ants' pheromones. My housekeeper and I make sure to only use vinegar when cleaning my floors, countertops, walls, and furniture. It is an effective and eco-friendly natural cleaner. If you can keep getting rid of the ants' pheromonal trails, the ants will be like tourists without Google Maps and won't be able to do what they need to do properly. Next, keep all food away. Make sure not a single crumb can be found anywhere. Bring all garbage outside, and after meals, clean up immediately. Place leftovers in the fridge, as well as any other open food. I highly recommend you follow what I do in this video if you have an ant problem. Make your place a ghost town for the ants, and they will be more likely to move out of your home. This includes, and here's a big one, pet food. If you have a dog or cat, pest ants love your pet's food. Don't leave the food out 24/7. Leave them out just for the duration that your pets are eating. You can even place your pet's food bowls in a pan of water to create a moat while the food is left out. Always clean up the areas after meals of any crumbs left behind as well. Another thing you can do is create this super slippery stuff, baby powder mixed with rubbing alcohol, the mixture we use to line our outworlds. When dried, it is super slippery for ants, so place a band of this mixture around the legs of tables you don't want the ants to have access to. You can place the band of mixture in discreet places under the table so guests don't raise their eyebrows. Hopefully these tips, when applied over time, will help you get rid of these feral pest ants. It may take a while, even several months, but basically the ants live where they're getting the resources they need. And if you cut them off from these resources, they have no choice but to move out. So be as persistent as the feral ants are, and stick with it. And you may see them dwindling in numbers over time. There is, however, in my mind, one ultimate eco-friendly solution to getting rid of pest ants, but it just hasn't been invented yet. And that is, someone needs to hack into their ant programming. Check this. So ants are actually very simple creatures that are programmed to perform a specific set of tasks to specific stimuli. For example, as you saw earlier, the feral black crazy ants smelled a here's food pheromone laid down by ants coming from our drop of honey. And the ants simply followed the pheromone trail to the honey. If they smell a time to move the colony out to so-and-so place pheromone, the workers will pick up the brood and guide the queen to the new location. In fact, this simple programming is how the ant circle of death phenomenon works in ants. It is possible for a trail of ants to somehow double on themselves and keep moving in an inescapable circle until they tire out and die of exhaustion. They're unable to reason, hey, we're going in a circle and getting nowhere. Let's stop and try something else. Instead, they just follow the biochemical instructions to keep moving to their mysterious destination and ask no questions. So, therefore, the only eco-friendly way I could think of to get rid of pest ants is if someone could analyze the biochemical makeup of these pheromones that get ants to move somewhere and duplicate it in the lab, then use this synthetic pheromonal solution to lead ants out of one's home or in some kind of circle of death. Of course, there would be some challenges because, well, there are thousands of ant species which presumably use different pheromonal languages. But imagine if we could come up with pheromone solutions for the most common domestic pest ants. That scientist inventor would create the ultimate eco-friendly solution to millions of people's struggle with pest ants in the home around the world. I see a multi-million dollar idea here. Perhaps that person may be you, watching out there. You, a member of the AC family. See? Now who says keeping ants can't improve the world in a huge way? Thank you guys so much for watching this week's video, and until next time, it's ant love forever. And yes, including those feral ants. What's up, AC family? So what did you think? These savage ants are really pesky little buggers, aren't they? If anything, perhaps they're an example of persistence is the key to success. I mean, look at this destructive ant risking its life to get a drink of water in this aquarium where fish would eat it. Now, if this video scared you folks who may be traveling to tropical countries because you're afraid they'll get in your bed while you're sleeping, don't worry, because the secret to having your space ant-free is air conditioning. This is what I do in my bedroom, and the ants never come in because it's way too cold for them. And as usual, Inner Colony, I've placed a hidden cookie for you guys here. For those of you who would just like to watch extended play footage of the ants in this video, along with some relaxing music. And we can't end the video without the AC question of the week. Last week, we asked, name one of the landmarks along the path to the Dark Knight's new hybrid nest and outworld. Congratulations to Blue Helium, who correctly answered, the Knight's Drop. We also accepted the Dragon Stairway, the AC Plateau, the DK Bridge, the Cavern of Darkness, the Wooden Cliffs, Silver Rock Canyon, and the Silver Glacier. Congratulations, Blue Helium, you just won a free ebook handbook from our shop. For this week's question of the week, we ask, name one method to help keep ants out of your home. Leave your answer in the comment section and you could win a free ant t-shirt from our shop. Hope you can subscribe to our channel as we upload a new ant video every Saturday at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Join the AC family and let's discover the amazing world of ants together. It's Ant Love Forever.